question is technology taking over the world?
Hello?
Of course. Technology. Look, this man is on his phone right now.
Exhibit A, look at this. Yeah. On two phones.
I'm on the
this
phone.
This is what thinks he's
Samsung.
Look. No, go ahead. What were you going to say?
I'm just saying, technology is going to take over this world. Because, first of all, y'all can't do without it right now anyway.
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Let your mom take your phone. Let's go.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Please, right.
I'm okay.
Right.
You know, I don't have friends anyway, so. I can do it on the phone.
Wow.
Damn. I can tell you why
only weirdos will like be
so
straight.
So you call me a weirdo?
You feel me? Cause like,
no,
I'm telling you right now, you take my phone, we fine. And that's all I gotta say.
Cause you're lame.
I feel like I'm a cool kid. I feel as though we have had this phone for so long, like we had a phone for so long that we can't live without it.
It's
we're
not
so
even
used to having it for so long is that
it's not even that. It's
I think
the
I
fact
can live without my phone. I can live without.
No,
I can live without.
All right. So then. Okay. Well, let me put you in a scenario right now. Right.
G, here, hold my phone for the whole.
EMP. An EMP hits. For those of you that don't know what an EMP is,
mm-hmm.
It's an electromagnetic pulse.
Mm-hmm.
What happens when that takes place is anything that runs on technology, on electricity, I should say, is shut down. It's no longer usable. Computers, lights, TVs, everything is shut down.
They're gonna go crazy.
What are you going to do to kill the time? What are you gonna do to occupy yourself?
First of all, people
gonna
be rich. That's all I gotta say.
Okay,
people,
okay. I'm gonna be.
You don't have time to waste no more.
Reading no books, nothing.
Half your time be on the phone, be on the TV.
Okay,
the calendar.
That's when you go outside and you make friends and you interact with people. That's what we used to do
about
a decade ago. Not even a decade ago. That's what we used to do.
Hey, G, that's what I'm gonna do. You see this right here? Push-ups. I'm gonna get big.
You're not gonna do it because you don't have a phone to record. People go, you gonna show people.
Why would
you wanna show people?
I don't even show people that I work out now.
Because.
Okay, so what you're saying, you're caught up in your phone.
Hello?
We're not.
Hello?
So you're the
issue. Y'all not.
Hello?
So you the issue.
Hello?
So
this y'all. It's just y'all.
So Romar, you're like a crackhead, not a mini, you're a crackhead.
You're right now.
So you're a crackhead. You're a phone head.
Okay, so look. Another example, when people are trying to get from place to place, how often do you guys use your GPS as opposed to people that used to use
put you in the desert that
to get to where they need to go?
Alright, that's different.
You learn your streets.
Of course I'm going to use my phone. Look, man, I don't got no time to be getting over. First of all, you got to go purchase the map, do you not? On your phone, it's what? Free. Right?
You have to buy the phone, though. So.
But it still comes with
no,
the
there's
phone.
Maps that are free of it.
Okay, well, G, we're not talking about that, so you be quiet.
But look,
oh, so you just going to cut me off like I wasn't speaking. Go ahead, fine.
Okay, but look, what I'm trying to say is, on the map, like, you got to be reading, and then you got streets going like this all over the place, but on your phone, you got...
So then how do people use maps then? Because people,
I don't know.
The way people use maps is if you know what street you're on, you look for that street on the map and you follow it. That's
that,
all.
That
that's all
is like
put in
the
How many people died
because they didn't know how to read the map?
Okay, here's the thing. You're saying
thank you.
It's teeny tiny streets, but if you're looking for at a local map, it's not going to be teeny tiny streets.
Right.
If you're looking at a United States map or a country map or whatever, it's not going to be streets. It's going to be turnpikes and
my point
major
roads
is better on your phone.
I feel like no matter what.
No, but that's an example.
The reason why technology
they depend on their phone because think about it. Oh, I can't say that. So athletes, they always posting videos of themselves. Athletes in high school, they post videos of themselves onto the internet with their phone to get noticed. So
to get a brand.
Yeah, but then
on their phone.
Yeah, but then before phones had a camera capability, you had people that actually had cameras, camcorders that videoed the athlete in action and then created a highlight reel
for that athlete. The topic is a phone.
The phone is qualified in the technology category because people depend on their phone so much that they kind of lose sight on what they could really do without it. You get what I'm saying? So that's just what I'm putting out there. Go. You can leave.
When you really think about it, G, technology.
Hold on, hold that thought. Not to mention, the video people, they make money because not everybody had access to a camera to make their own highlight reel. So that was actually another job, another source of income, because they were able to do it for people. Now, they're no longer able to do it because everybody has their own camera on their phone.
That's what I'm saying. Also, even music videos. How you gonna record a music video without technology?
You know why?
Technology. Exactly. So they need technology to get themselves out there.
In order
to
technology.
Understandable. But when does it become fully dependent on technology versus just using technology to do day to day?
You have to. If you're in the music industry, you're dependent on technology.
Of course, because
at the end of the day, you have to look at it. It's no company that is not, if you're not branded right, really, like with social media, you're not gonna get hired at job. Let's be real. If you're trying to be like a big corporation, right. Even CEOs have social media accounts. You see what I'm saying? Even our president has social media accounts. Mm-hmm. That's how far technology has gotten us. Now, if you're seeing how we use technology for the good or the bad, that's a different subject to be brought up.
No, I'm saying, are we becoming too dependent, or are we just using it?
Yeah,
what we need to do.
No, it's just like remember, every I learned this in U.S. history. My gosh, every generation, right? Like the 1800s and 1900s, the 20th century, all that. They all had that one invention that just made life easier for them.
Yeah.
Technology made life easier for us. Like back in the day for the farmers, the beginning of the farmers, the second industrial revolution, they literally had stuff like where it, you know, I'm talking about the plowers and all that stuff to make life easier for them. We're not in the hand labor business anymore. We are literally in the technology labor. Mm-hmm. So, If I'm a businessman and I can make something that's gonna make my job easier, right. You're telling me I'm not gonna take it?
No, that's fine. But then what about the places where technology actually replaces the person's job? Like the self checkouts at supermarkets.
Either way.
But look, this is how I feel about it. Hold on, I'm gonna let you speak. My fault. This is how I feel about that. That's a blessing if you look at it. Because first of all, you're getting paid, let's say $8.50 to bag some groceries. Some simple, easy job.
Or be a cashier.
Yeah, to be a cashier, some simple, easy job. But guess what? Now you can go to school, learn a trade, how to fix that same thing when it breaks down. And guess what? You can make a contract with Walmart. You can make a contract with Publix. Mm-hmm. You can make a contract with Winn-Dixie. See, people don't think like that. Now, okay. That's why people complain.
Understandable. Now, let's take it a step further. What about artificial intelligence?
That's different. I ain't messing with that. You saw what happened in Avengers, right? All right. Ultron almost killed the whole world. I ain't with that. Nope.
Matrix. Terminator. iRobot.
Nope. I'm good.
When they become self-aware of how advanced they are and what they can do, that
and they get
can't.
Jealous. They get jealous of our emotions. They get jealous because they can't have emotions
have
that
feelings.
We have. Yeah. Like, my thing is, bro, if you're smart and you know everything, why you want to have feelings? Like, why you want to love? Like,
but
so what?
you need emotions to go through our life, because you're emotionless.
You're a robot. You don't have no life.
But
you're
like,
yourself.
Look at this. I feel like what they're saying is
something.
They're gonna use.
Brianna's a robot. She doesn't love me.
Can you? What they're saying is they're gonna be using like computerized cabs now, like Ubers and stuff like that.
Like
people enjoy
cars.
Yeah. Like people
cars.
Enjoy doing those type of stuff. But like when you take that from them, like what are they gonna be using now? Like what are they gonna do? Sit at home, get fat, watching TV all day,
no,
every day?
That's for the people who don't have ambitions.
The reason
like
why,
I was saying.
But I also
gotta go out. Think about the people who make those.
Technology is getting all over. What about people who they did not go to school to learn that trade? They did not go to school.
That's what I'm saying. You now have a chance to
trade. Okay, if you just got out of a job and you wanna go to school, you're gonna have to pay for it with money.
Yeah, if you don't have a job, like
you do, you
money.
Do know, you do know a lot of companies do pay you off when
okay,
you get
yes,
lose
yes,
your job, right?
Okay,
yeah, I like what's
so, yes. And you know, a lot of trade schools don't cost that much to go learn how to fix something. It only takes 9 months, so there's really no excuse anybody has. There's really no excuse.
Technology Uber driver, like is that what you said? They won't be able to see or tell if some driver just had a seizure in their car and they swerving across the road. They're not gonna know what.
Yeah, like what happened when it breaks down?
Person,
like what are you gonna do?
A real person scenario will know what to do in that situation because they'll know how to react. But the computer just gonna have one set to stop. My what thing if the is, person just turned around and hit you?
Okay,
you
my thing is, in that Uber situation, right, are they saying that no Uber is going to be there? Because remember, who's going to make money off of that? Who's going to be sending the car
out? The owner of Uber.
The owner of Uber doesn't have time to do all that. And the Uber is not, there really is no sole person, there really is no owner of Uber. Uber is basically like a chance for everybody to basically make extra money. So they're not taking,
but it is an owner of the whole company.
It's an owner of a company, but they make money off the app, they don't make money off the people.
And they're gonna, like, the app itself, the company, is they're now, like, providing, computerized cars.
That take more money out of their pockets.
Yeah, but that, then they no, wait, get money.
That
and,
way,
like,
they don't have to pay these people no more. They don't have to pay people no more.
Uber don't pay me. I pay Uber.
How?
Dude, you don't pay Uber? Who credit card they take? They take, the owners are mine.
I'm talking about driver, bros.
They take, the owners are mine.
I'm talking about driver.
I pay the driver.
Is bro, you
I pay the driver.
Right? Listen, it's a card, right? But instead like, of look, paying, they have to pay the driver to drop you off.
Yes, especially with, Go. Especially with Lyft, I just saw this ad actually a couple days ago, and they pay you $450 for 32 cars that you, 32 transportations that you take or whatever. That's from the company. That's not from the person that's paying them to take them where they need to go.
But at the same time, that's gonna, okay, I get that. All right, my fault for that. Because I thought it was a whole different system. But at the same time, I don't think anybody realizing that it's gonna cost the company more money, because remember, the company does not come out their pocket for your car. If anything happens to your car, that's whose liability? You.
But they still pay for your insurance.
Itself, but like when they get those self-driving cars, those robotic cars, like what are they gonna do with the app? Now they're gonna shut the app off. Like they're gonna shut it off because that's the, they're gonna want to make money for themselves and not like provide for
you. Courtney, I feel like you're thinking.
Yeah, but they're gonna shut the app off for like regular Uber drivers, like human Uber drivers, and then create a whole new app for like
Courtney. I feel like you're
driving car. Like that's why.
Courtney, I feel like you think it's too short term because. Long term, if they buy their own cars and they have computer driving, they don't have to pay nobody to drive the car. They have to pay.
But now you have to pay people.
All they're going
to
do is have profit because they already got the cars bought.
But here's the thing. You're going to have to pay the robot cars. That's short term. That's not short term. That's a long term issue. Okay, but here's the thing. If you pay off everybody that made the robot car, that's done. That's
Car after car, and how many states are in the United States?
Listen,
50. But you don't
how
know
many people are around
be,
the world
like, putting them in all but 50 here's states. The thing. That's the thing.
What's the
They're
point
gonna
doing?
Start off with one state first to see how that gonna go. Like to see how like okay, is it progressing good? Is people using these cars like what
okay,
are
so
you doing?
Okay, so y'all that's
if
short
it
term.
Doesn't work
so,
out.
It's like owning a house. You're thinking short term. If you're renting, you only pay like $1,000 a month. You think it's short term because you only pay that quick $1,000 right now. But long term, if you pay the whole $120, you own the house. That's your property for generations.
And then you can make money off of that afterwards.
At the end of the day, this is how I feel. Technology, yes, is taking over the world. That's obvious. But at the same time, when we talk about how companies are progressing with it, companies still people are complaining like there's not going to be no jobs for it. Yes, there is. It's up to the individual to go look for it. You see what I'm saying? Like, think about it. Nobody, like, to make that, don't people got to put that together?
Yeah.
Don't people got to put a drum set together? Yeah. A drum set is basically just like a robot. Someone got to put it together.
Yeah, but then they can create
robots. It's like a technological assembly line. Even though there's still going to be work, it's going to be work. But it's going to be more. But I understand what both sides are saying.
But I understand what he's saying in terms of, okay, if that robot comes along where now they're doing the human's job, now the human's job is to find out, okay, how can I get a job in maintaining that robot that has to build the thing that I would have built as a human being?
We get, see, and right you know now, technology is hurting us because it's making us complacent. is making us very complacent. Like a lot of people, they live this, they can't really be a superstar, so guess what they do? They go to social media to be a superstar. Like I know there's a lot of
people. It's a good platform. It's a very good platform.
It has disadvantages and it has advantages. Like you said earlier with companies, like if you're in the fashion industry or the music industry, like you're gonna rely on technology and social media. But like with the whole robot situation, like
robot situation.
Listen here.
Okay, I'm not saying that technology is not a bad is a bad platform. It's a very, 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 very.
It depends on who's using it. That's what we're saying.
Mm-hmm. Not to mention, there are things, there are different venues you could take where technology, no matter what technology you create, they can't replace the human instinct.
Yeah.
For example, creative jobs. You can't get a robot songwriter.
Yeah, you can't get
you know what I'm saying? You can't get a you can probably get CG actors, but you still need that human voice to bring that to life.
And you can't get a robot.
You still need the you still need a human being to animate that animated character.
Yeah, that's
you know what I'm saying? So
that's why
no matter what technology is made, there's still gonna be a human somewhere pulling the strings somehow.
Let me ask you a question.
That's what I'm saying, it's just gonna decrease. It's just gonna
Keelan, would you rather see LeBron James or would you rather see a robot LeBron James?
What are you talking about?
I'd rather see a robot.
That's what I'm saying.
Wait,
that's what G was saying. He was saying that the human qualities, what we like.
There's certain human instincts and qualities that cannot be
replaced. But the ones that can,
they'll try, but they can't. Like even like you know, people watch UFC fights.
Yeah.
But now they also have
robot
fights.
But ain't nobody want to see no robot break down his jaw not broken. Guess what?
It's not.
A screw done came out.
Oh, look at that saw cut through that wheel. Oh, snap.
That makes no sense.
No, there's really a show called BattleBots.
Yeah, you never seen
people
it? I know it. But like.
Show them. Yeah.
Yeah, it's really. That's I'm not going to lie. It's actually fun to watch, too.
That's for
the thing is, if robots do take over, the thing is, they can't exactly take over because.
What you mean?
They can't take us over because we gon' control them.
We're not.
Did you not see that?
It's true, but the humans still found ways to outsmart what technology can't predict or foresee.
Cause they can't.
So you gotta be unpredictable with technology.
Remember, did you see how she found out what they were saying? The
vibration,
the sound vibration from the coffee.
But at the same time, do you think that the robot predicted that Shia LaBeouf was going to run into the middle and fire the gun in the middle of the national anthem?
No.
The technology couldn't predict that.
Yeah.
Like, there's certain things that technology just can't do.
See, my thing is, if I get a robot that's in my house and stuff like that, I'm going to tell my people at 24/7, let's do one thing a day that makes this robot be like, why the heck are they doing this? You see what I'm saying? If you do something like that, it throws it off. Because if you do the same thing every day,
it's just
it's just like when, I know it might be weird to use this term, but it's just like when a stalker's watching you day after day after day after day.
They learn your routine, they learn your
schedule. You wake up at 1, you leave the house at, you see what I'm saying, at 3.
Yeah.
They know this already. So 12:15, nah, I'm behind the door, bam, I got you. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you leave the house one day, 1:30, they like, what the heck, why are you leaving at 1:30 today? That's why a lot of time, like, people don't understand that. That's why you have to just be unpredictable. That's one thing that a robot can never do that humans can do, be unpredictable. Because robots, like, they think they know everything.
Yeah.
You can't know everything. Nobody knows everything, especially if someone made you. There's an error in you somewhere.
There's a failsafe.
Exactly. Like Ultron.
Mm-hmm.
His thing was he didn't want to be nothing like Tony Stark. Guess who made him? Tony Stark. So what did he end up being like? Tony Stark. So who's gonna figure him out? Tony Stark. It's simple, man. You just gotta be unpredictable, man. That's all
just
it is.
Just that simple. Did you get it now?
I've been getting it. It's just that
he has to tell me how he wrote it, and he didn't say anything.
No, because y'all was changing the story. Y'all was arguing.
Over here sleeping. I'm like,
No. Time out. Y'all was arguing, but y'all don't know what y'all arguing about.
We know exactly.
All of them saying the same thing, low key, G. That's why I'm sitting here just watching.
What is your
central point? What do you want to say?
What I'm saying is. We're like so caught up in technology right now. It's because once it first came, like All right, say we never had fruits in the whole world, right? We suddenly have fruit now. We're gonna be like, whoa, I can eat this. I can make juice out of this. My kids can eat it. Animals can eat it. It's just like technology. It's like we just figured it out, so we're gonna use it to the best of our ability. You feel me? So that's all I was saying.
I feel as though that it's only so much that technology can do, but it can do a lot. For example, with the Uber, they can make money off this because they can buy it and own it long term. But what technology can do is react to somebody who's having a seizure in the car.
The worst thing about, like, the main thing technology can't do, which is the biggest thing, which is why we have the advantage, is a mind of its own. It don't.
Technology can't have emotion.
Okay, like, going off of what Keelan said.
Technology can't have Brianna.
Hey.
I have Brianna.
Okay. Okay, so, like, going off of what you said, no emotion. Okay, so say if somebody that ordered an Uber was suicidal, and maybe the person driving the car would help their day and, like, help them not
say something.
Like, say something to, like save their life.
Yeah, like, a robot can't. How was your day, Bob?
Good.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Siri, they don't have the emotion.
Hey,
yeah.
Siri,
hey, no, real talk. My parents have, what's it called? The Amazon Echo? Mm-hmm. Not Echo, Alexa.
Alexa, yeah.
Yo, that thing is scary, yo.
I know.
Like, you add, like, one day I went up to it, I was like, good morning. Good morning, how are you? And it just tells me a joke. Just I didn't ask it to tell me a joke, it just told me a joke.
Garrett, like, did you know that G stands for Garrett?
I wouldn't be surprised if it said something like that, but I mean, and it'll have like legit conversations with you depending on what you ask it.
Yeah, yes or no questions.
So that's where our artificial intelligence comes from, right? Again, like we were saying.
Because it learns.
Yeah.
Like,
so
the same, like, it self-learns.
Exactly. But at the end of the day, man, we just all got to be careful and be safe. And you
walk around with EMPs.
And walk around with a Bible.
Hey.
Because if it go crazy, smack it, and I bet it die. Just like that.
Holy Ghost.
Or just open it. Just like,
and what? This has been another successful heated debate. Oh. Give yourselves a hand clap.
I love you, Mom and Brianna.
You know what?
Oh, what's
you
that? What's what? That lady girl name? What's her name again?
Miss Mulatto. If you see this, get out, man.
No,
get out, man.
No,
hey,
no,
Courtney, get out. I'm 17, baby. At time.
Listen,
I'm listening to your mixtape right now. G, check this out.
Mana General.
G, look.
Okay, y'all check out my IG.
Look, G. Look.
Queen.
Bam. Damn!